Hello, my name is Magnus, and today we will be talking about sizing. And this is normally a very big topic when it comes to buying a security solution, especially when it comes to firewall and load balancers. It's more or less impossible to know how much traffic you will have in 3 to 5 years, and therefore it's very hard to buy the right stuff. And if you do buy appliances and you think like you will have a traffic growth in 300%. What if you don't have that traffic growth? Then you have purchased an appliance that has a lot more performance than you actually need. Maybe it's not the worst case, but what if you buy an appliance that is smaller than you actually need after 6 months because you see a rapid growth in your traffic? Well, first of all, you have bought the wrong box. But maybe your data did not say that you will have that rapid growth over the next 6 months. So we will be talking about how you can think about this and how Checkpoint has done some of this to make it easier for you. So first of all, when it comes to appliances, they have fixed performance. So hardware is supplied from Checkpoint, the vendor. And Checkpoint also give you performance numbers. And this may change depending on the software version that you run on it. So your appliance can actually be stronger after a period of time because of new software updates. Then you also have the possibility to run them virtually. And that gives the possibility to autoscale if you want that sort of things. Normally this is based on cores, and performance numbers will also be provided from Checkpoint depending on what cloud vendor you're using. They will not be able to give you a performance number on your private cloud if you're running virtual appliances there. And the third and last option is open servers, and that's a third party server from like HP or IBM. These licenses are based on cores. You have no assistance on what performance numbers this sort of server will give you. I mean, you can buy a HP server with 8 cores. Either you buy a very slow CPU or you buy a high performance platinum super duper CPU, and it gives you great performance. But Checkpoint will not provide you any performance figures for the open servers. The easiest one is the cloud based, because either you have auto-scaling, so you can just add more and more cores after time if you grow, or if your need is actually decreasing. And the licenses are based on cores. Either it's pay-as-you-go or bring your own license. And here is a cutout from Checkpoint's website, how much performance you get on the different type of virtual machines in the public clouds. And you can see here like D2 version 2 gives 1.5 gigabit of firewall. It also gives 1.5 gigabit of IPS. Depending on how many cores this D2 version 2 has, that's how many licenses you need to run this server. And if you then have auto scaling, so it becomes a D4 version 2, then you need to add the numbers of cores that the D4 is actually using. So you can have a license pool, or you can pay as you go in the public clouds. In the private cloud, it's a bit harder. Then you need to do either some testing or just guess. But I guess you can take the performance numbers from the public cloud and try to translate them to your private cloud. The second option is to run appliances. And when it comes to appliances, Checkpoint is actually having a sizing tool available for partners where you can put in like traffic measurements. Like I have 1 gigabit of traffic with 1,000 users, and I uses these functions in the boxes, and that will give you an estimate together with how much you can grow on that specific appliance. And what makes it hard here is it actually depends on what sort of setup you will use. You can use Cluster Excel, load sharing, VSLS, or Maestro. And That gives you the possibility to buy different appliances depending on your setup. So it's a bit tricky. So let's take an example. When you do a cluster, more or less you always have an active standby. That means that you have a spare. And that spare, it still costs money. It needs to be sized to manage the load if the active member breaks. And within a data center, you have a lot of traffic and it needs to be up and running 24/7, so you can't really skip it. But you have one box that is more or less doing nothing if you don't have any issue or you don't do any maintenance on it. I wouldn't suggest you to buy a single box just to save money. It's better to have a cluster in any way. But it's a bit hard to justify if you're running, let's say, 10, 20, 30 gigabit of traffic to have a very high box or a very nice box just standing and pumping air and doing more or less nothing. Then, of course, you can have something called load sharing, and that is when you have both members active. The problem with this is that you don't have any limitations, so you can actually put more load than the cluster itself can take if one member go down. So in this case, we have 70% in each member, and if one breaks, then one member will have 140%, and more or less you're dropping traffic. Maybe it's worth it, maybe it doesn't happen so often, and maybe you can plan your maintenance when you have low traffic volume. But it's just you need to think about it, that you can have actually overuse the cluster or oversubscribe it. And having load sharing, it adds complexity and it also requires some extra things on the network. For example, multicast or similar. It depends on how you build the load sharing. There is one option to run VSX with VSLS. This also permits overuse and it adds complexity. But VSX, it allows you to build virtualized firewalls, same as Context if you come from Cisco. And that means that you can have active members on member 1, 2, and 3. The firewall 1, this one, it cannot be active on all members at the same time. It can only be active on one member. So this means that you need to split up your traffic on more gateways or more firewalls. For example, maybe you can offload your guest network on a separate firewall. Maybe you can have your data center on a separate firewall. But this gives you the possibility to use multiple members at the same time, so you don't need to have boxes standing alone around and just pumping air. So you could have three members, and you can, for example, count so the two members can have 100% of the load, so you can lose one member, or five or six, depending on how many you need. You can actually have up to 13 members in the same VSX cluster. I wouldn't recommend it. Maybe you should have like up to four or six members and then make a new cluster. But this is the possibility. And this is more effective because you don't sync the traffic everywhere. You only sync the traffic between the active and the standby node. So, for example, here, the active member on the active VS on member 1 has a standby on member 2 and has a backup on member 3. The state or the sync is only between member 1 and member 2 for this specific VS or virtual firewall, meaning we don't need to send sync traffic to all the members at the same time and eating up our bandwidth. If you have a load sharing cluster on like five members, most of your traffic will be syncing all the traffic, so it's not really effective. And VSLS, I believe, is a patented technology by Checkpoint. This is one way to get more performance on the boxes, Yes, VSX and VSLS cost licensing, but we don't talk about that right now. And the last option, it actually came in, I believe, in 2019, and that's Maestro. This is a hyperscale solution. It's more or less a physical box that you purchase from Checkpoint. And here you can connect multiple appliances. So this is for appliance only. The other clustering types, they are also possible for open servers. So in Maestro, you can go from one appliance up to 52. And the reason why I don't put one here is because you still want some redundancy in the hardware, and you can of course have two Maestros. If this is a good solution for you, it depends on your physical layout, how you want to scale the things. But you can have very high performance and very high throughput, and it count as either it can count as one firewall or it can count as many firewalls depending on how you set up the Maestro. But that will be a separate video because Maestro is a whole different topic by itself. I hope you did like this video, and see you in the next one. Take care. Bye.